We have described the propagation of light as an electromagnetic wave. But how does light behave when it encounters a different medium? In this video, we will focus on the behavior of light at the interface of two different media. The learning objectives of this video are to understand how light behaves propagating through a medium and what happens at the interface of two different media. To that end, we will look at the different material properties involved. Finally, we will learn how these properties are related and how to apply them. What better way is there to start our discussion than with one of nature's prettiest phenomena, a rainbow in a clear blue sky? Incident light encounters tiny water particles in the ambient air. Since not all wavelengths are refracted equally, we can observe the full spectrum of the visible light stacked neatly in a colorful rainbow. Rainbows are perhaps the most famous examples of the refraction and dispersion of light. Let's start by defining both concepts. Refraction is a change in the propagation direction of a wave due to a change in its speed. The speed of the wave depends on the medium through which it propagates. The refractive index of a material, denoted by n, is a measure of how easily light propagates through the material. A medium with a refractive index of 2, for example, indicates that the light moves in that respective medium with half the speed in reference to light moving in vacuum. Air has a refractive index very close to 1, which means that the light propagates through air almost at the speed of light in a vacuum. The shown figure illustrates half a propagating wave encountering a different medium. At the interface of the two media, part of the wave is reflected while the other part is transmitted into the new medium. If the wave reflects off a surface with a higher refractive index than that of the medium in which the wave is traveling, the reflected wave will exhibit a phase shift of 1 pi. This is shown in the figure on the right side, where the wave reflected off the light blue surface exhibits a 1 pi phase shift. Transmitted waves and waves reflected off the surface of a medium with a lower refractive index are in phase with the incident wave. Inside the light blue medium, the transmitted wave will propagate at a fraction of its initial speed. This fraction is equal to the ratio between the refractive index of the initial medium to the refractive index of the new medium, here the blue medium. The speed and direction of a light wave in a certain medium are described by the refractive index of that medium. The refractive index of a material, however, is generally wavelength dependent. Therefore, the various wavelengths contained in a beam of light will exhibit different behavior when encountering a new medium. The wavelength dependence of a material's refractive index and the consequential difference in refraction is called dispersion. The dispersion of the different colors contained in white light is what gives rise to our rainbow. White light, containing all the wavelengths of the visible spectrum, hits a water droplet. The wavelength-dependent refractive index of the water droplet refracts the different colors into slightly different angles. The beam is then reflected off the backside of the droplet before being transmitted from the droplet. As shown in the figure, red light is finally transmitted from the droplet at an angle of 42 degrees, while blue light exits the droplet at 40 degrees. These different angles of refraction causes the colors of the visible spectrum to split and form a rainbow. So far, we have implicitly assumed that the media through which light propagates are non-absorbing. Materials used for solar cells, however, need to absorb light to function properly. Therefore, we will now discuss the full refractive index to include absorption as well. In general, the optical properties of an absorbing medium are described by a complex electric permittivity epsilon. This complex electric permittivity consists of a real part denoted by epsilon prime and an imaginary part denoted by epsilon double prime. The refractive index is given as the square root of epsilon. It is complex 2. Here, kappa denotes the imaginary part of the refractive index. The real part of the refractive index, n, is the term that we have been discussing so far, defining the ratio of the speed of light in a medium to the speed of light in vacuum. The imaginary part, kappa, describes the extinction of light when traveling through a certain medium. The extinction coefficient is related to the absorption coefficient through the photon wavelength. The absorption coefficient is a measure of the absorbed light intensity per unit path length and is an important property of a material. This relation clearly shows that the larger the extinction coefficient, the greater the light absorption in a medium will be. The law that describes the light absorption in medium is called the Lambert-Beer law. The Lambert-Beer law is used to determine the light intensity at a certain point in a medium after traveling a distant x. The law states that the intensity at x is equal to the initial intensity times the exponential function of the product of the absorption coefficient and the path length x. The light intensity therefore decays exponentially while traveling through a certain absorbing medium. To get better acquainted with light absorption in solar cells, we take a look at spectral absorption coefficient of several semiconductor materials. The absorption coefficient can vary orders of magnitude between semiconductors and even between photon wavelengths. If we focus, for instance, on the absorption of blue and red photons in silicon, we can read from the graph that the absorption coefficient for blue photons at 400 nanometers is about 9 times 10 to the power 4. The absorption coefficient for red photons at 700 nanometers is about 2 times 10 to the power 3. Let's say we are interested in how thick our silicon solar cell has to be in order to absorb 90% of the incident light. We rewrite the Lambert-Beer law so that it gives the path length x as a function of the intensity. 90% absorption means that the intensity at thickness x should be 10%. When we enter the absorption coefficient into the equation, we can see that 90% of the blue photons are absorbed at a thickness of 0.26 micrometers. Red photons require a much thicker absorber layer. Red photons have to travel 11.5 micrometers through silicon for 90% of the light intensity to be absorbed. We can imagine that absorber layers has to be quite thick indeed in order to absorb a large fraction of the infrared photons as well. In summary, at the interface of two different media, light is either reflected or transmitted. Light reflected of a high refractive index surface exhibits a phase shift of 1 pi, while transmitted light propagates under a refractive angle. The angle of refraction is described by Snell's law, which we will discuss in the next video. If the refractive indices of the media are strongly wavelength dependent in the visible spectrum, a light beam can be dispersed into its colorful constituents. We discussed how the complex electric permittivity leads to a complex refractive index. The real part of the complex refractive index describes the speed at which light propagates through the medium, while the imaginary part describes the extinction of light. The imaginary part of the refractive index is directly related to the absorption coefficient, which describes the light intensity absorption through the Lambert-Beer law. Finally, we saw how the absorption coefficient is strongly wavelength dependent and can vary orders of magnitude between wavelengths and semiconductors. In the next two videos, we will see how the refractive index determines the behavior of light at the interface of two media.